In today's talk on surgery, a condition that we fortunately don't see very often, and those are tumors of the biliary tree. Now, we see patients that are slightly older, and we do have a male predominance, and they present to us, by and large, with painless jaundice. But you've got to think of the anatomy of the biliary tree, and I link to some images in the description below. Just always think of the anatomy. We divide the biliary tree usually in thirds when it comes to tumors of the biliary tree. We have the lower third, we have the middle third, and then we have the upper third, which is really by the hilum and the left and right hepatic ducts as they start going into, or at least into the liver. Now, the ones in the lower third and the middle third, they present more common. They'll make up more than half of the cases, and the upper third will be less than half of the cases. The ones that are in the lower third and the middle third, and specifically those that develop below where the common hepatic duct and the cystic duct combine to form the common bile duct, if the tumor is below that, we are going to see distension of the gallbladder. And that has a name, it's called Cavossius sign, where we have this painless distended gallbladder in a patient with jaundice. Now, these patients have nausea, they have all patients really with cholangiocarcinoma can have weight loss, they do feel unwell, and they have pruritus, and then they have obviously this deepening jaundice. It is an obstructive jaundice, so they are going to have dark urine and pale stools, as we see with cholangiocarcinomas as an obstructive cause of jaundice. And anyway, so these patients with their bile ducts, they really need confirmation, with their bile duct carcinomas, they need confirmation of the disease and delineating the anatomy. When it comes to the tumors in the upper third, we do have a bit of a classification for them. You might be asked about those. We have a type 1, type 2, 3, and 4, and type 3 and 4s, those are inside of the liver, secondary bile ducts. 2 will be above the hilum, and 1 will really be at the common level of the common hepatic duct. And remember, that's above the level where the cystic duct is going to enter the biliary tree, so you're not going to have this Cavossius sign with this large palpable gallbladder that we do see. Remember, there's a special tumor, we call it a Klatskin tumor. That's really for tumors around the biliary, the bifurcation, or where the left and right hepatic ducts combine to form the common hepatic duct. So it is all about imaging then. We will do CT scans, we will do MRIs, MRCPs, just to delineate the anatomy. And it is about resectability in these instances. So these patients really have to be referred to a unit that deals with these resections. They are big resections. If we're talking the lower third, we are talking pancreatic duodenectomies. If we're talking the upper third tumors, these might involve large liver resections or liver resections with maintenance of some form of intrahepatic bile duct system still to maintain. And you have to hook up again, remember, the hepatic ducts with the enteric system so that there is flow of bile into the bowel. So these are really big resections, and they have to be done, or you have to refer these patients as soon as possible. The prognosis is not so good. The further distal these tumors are, the easier they are picked up, and the better the prognosis is, and the easier it is to get resection. So it is all about resection with clear margins. That is the treatment and for these patients. You have to get resection with clear margins, so resectability is very important. These tumors, remember, they invade locally and they spread via the lymphatics. Many units will do a laparoscopy initially after deciding, after imaging, after delineating the anatomy with an ERCP, MRCP, finding out exactly what is going on, looking at the reserve of these patients. Can they go through this major surgery? We'll add to that a laparoscopy just to finally determine whether the resectability is possible. And in some instances, you might find deposits in the peritoneal cavity or other local invasions that were not seen on preoperative investigations. And that idea of going into the abdomen then for primary resection, that management plan is aborted at that time. So fortunate tumors that we see, really, you must know something about it. It's very easy to answer questions on carcinomas of the biliary tree. Just think about the anatomy.